Hi, I'm Craig Frazier, and I'm here to show you some reduction techniques using Kratex's Illustration Colors and Tim Gore's Bloodline. We got some Bloodline here, blood red, one of my favorite colors in the line. Always want to give it a good shake. Now, when reducing this, there's a couple of different reducers you can use. I prefer to use actually the 4012. And very simple, we'll just squeeze a little bit of it right in here. Now, can you use it right out of the bottle? Sure, you can. But for like hyper reduction of getting really extra details, you want to add some reducer to it. In which case, I'm going to use some of the 4012 right here. And I don't need a lot, maybe just 5 to 10%. Always add a little bit at a time. That way, if you need more, you can add it, but it's a lot easier than going back and forth and adding more pigment or more reducer. A little bit of a stirring blends very, very well. This paint is already very, very thin paint, very, very finely ground pigment. I use this stuff for a lot of work, everything from canvas work to illustration, maquette work. I've been working with Tim, and he uses it on just about everything. He developed the paint, and he uses it on almost everything in the studios, from appliances to like small maquettes, details. Amazing stuff. Got it all nice and mixed in there. You can either pour it right in your airbrush from there. I prefer to actually keep it inside a little bottle because it will start drying in the air, and that way you can also give it a good shake every now and then. So there you go, your blood red reduced down with the 4012 reducer. Okay, we've shown you the real easy reduction of just adding your 4012 to your Kratex Illustration or Bloodline colors. Now we're going to take it up a notch. Now, what do I mean by that? We're going to add some 4030 stuff right here. What this is, it's a type of balancing clear. It basically improves adhesion, improves sprayability, makes the paint a whole heck of a lot tougher. So by using this, just makes the paint more fortified. You can do two different ways. You can take it and just immediately add it right into this mix here. You got your 4012 and your illustration. But what I would recommend doing is, if you haven't mixed the paint yet, do it ahead of time. And the reason I do that is, and I'll tell you, always give it a shake. This paint does settle, and this, even though there's no color in here, it does have stratified, layers. Let me see, got my stick over here, and we're gonna add our 4012. How much do we add? Not much, maybe 5, 10%. Don't need a whole lot. And just give it a good stir. What we're doing is we're creating a 4030, 4012 slurry that we can then, when it's all said and done, we can just mix up or give a good shake to our bloodline. Add it in there. How much we're going to add? I don't know, maybe 50%. You can go less if you like. I'd say the minimum you want to add is about maybe 10% of the 4030 slurry to your bloodline. Anything less than that is pointless. But it gives it a good, lock it down nicely. And then no more than 50% is really necessary. Mix is really, really great. And right there you've got a very fortified version of the bloodline's blood red. We can add it right in here. Well, maybe it's not going to make any difference. Say, well, that's your other mix. It'll mix right in. Take it, give it a good shake, and it's ready to spray. Now, there is a consideration here, a little bit of a caveat. The reason I may want to actually keep these separate is, as soon as you add the 4030 to these paints, they become stronger, like I said. Now, what if you're using removal techniques, like erasing, or maybe you use your Q-tip with a little bit of acetone or a little bit of 4012, or sometimes I use isopropyl alcohol on it to remove paint. I made the mistake of mixing these 4030s up because I was always doing it with like maquettes and other things. I mix it up and use it on a canvas, and I couldn't get the paint to erase. The eraser would not, it was literally that tough. So I was able to figure out how to fix it from that, but it wasn't a bad mistake. It was actually a good mistake. I realized how strong this 4030 really makes the paint. Why would you need it to be that strong? Well, illustration and canvas, you don't really need it that strong. But what if I'm working on a maquette? What if I'm working on some latex? What if I'm working on some other products, like some hard urethane, or just a hard surface in general? The fortification really makes it a lot stronger, and you're going to have less delamination issues. Well, there's a better way of even mixing it than what I showed you right here, grabbing a big bottle. And the reason I would want to do that is, this way you can make up a slurry of your 4012 and your 4030, mix it up ahead of time. Like we did that little version, just in a bigger version, put it off to the side and let it sit. And then whenever you're mixing up your colors, you can grab an empty bottle, pour in your illustration paint, and then go ahead and add your slurry in. The reason I want you to do this is, I don't want this paint sitting around a lot. I want you to mix to spray. It's what my partner Dion always says, don't waste your materials. But also, there's a shelf life on this paint once you add a reducer or once you add the balancing clear. Some people don't like that. They say, oh, I don't like paint with a shelf life. It's a good thing. When you're adding these reducers or balancing clears, you're improving the drying process, you're improving the adhesing process, the sprayability of it, the fact that it won't delaminate, the fact that it'll bond other materials or other surfaces much better with these mixes in. If you put them in ahead of time, yeah, it might save you having to mix them, but then that paint's going to have a very low shelf life and it's just not a good, reliable paint. At Createx, they're much more concerned with giving you the best paint possible, not the quickest or the cheapest. They want to make sure it's the best. And so in this situation, the best requires a little bit of custom tailoring like we're showing you right here. Another reason it's good to do it ahead of time and let it sit, you should always, if you're worried about sprayability, I discovered an interesting trick. If you let the paint sit anywhere from 5 to 15 minutes after it's mixed, it is a whole different paint in how it sprays, especially for fine details in my Micron. It will literally just flow so much better. And this has to do with a lot of different paint systems in Createx. This 4012 and the 4030, it starts emulsifying the pigment. And it just kind of melts it all together, makes it just spray really, really nice. Very important for full-size spraying on cars when using some of the other systems out there, including this one right here. Speaking of cars, I know this is an illustration paint. I know Tim Gore used it for, you know, a lot of models, maquettes, a lot of appliances in the movies. It's done in a whole heck of a lot of movies, but it's also an automotive grade. When you mix that 4030 in, this stuff is toe-to-toe with some of the best automotive paints out there. Matter of fact, the pigments in here are automotive grade pigments. That is the highest grade pigment you can get, bar none, period. So you have an illustration paint that by adding a little bit of 4030, you now have an automotive grade mural paint. It's freaking amazing. So hope you enjoy those little tricks and techniques I showed you, and I will see you next time.